A relative said, wow, your legs are bigger than everybody else's in the picture. I don't think like a strong and healthy body doesn't always translate in a skinny body.
She's broken many barriers. She was one of India's first improv comedians to being the first and only female judge on Comicstaan season 1. She's hosted the General Fun game show, Queens of Comedy and Improv All-Stars.
We have with us today the fabulous queen of improv, Kaneez Surka, in conversation with Femina.
Yay!
Hey, Kaneez, thank you so much for being on the show with us today.
Thank you, Ananya, for having me.
Kaneez, it's 2020. Indian women are still subject to unreal standards of beauty. Why do you think that is?
Yeah, a lot of times, like, I feel like that's what women have been known for is, like, I was taught, like, growing up from a lot of different people that one way of getting ahead in life is by being beautiful. Like, that's what everyone kept sort of indoctrinating me, is that, like, if you're beautiful, you'll get ahead in life. And from a young age, I realized that was not my forte. I don't think I can do this beautiful thing, which is why I developed my personality, to be honest, which I believe is why I became funny, is because I was told I was not beautiful. So I was like, okay, well, then how else am I going to... It's okay, I don't feel that way now. but growing up, that was like something of a concern. And I think that's why I developed my personality and I developed comedy, was because I was like, okay, well, then I need another skill in life to get ahead. And I'm so glad that this is the skill I have, because beauty does fade, but my comedy and my personality will be like, I can do so much more with my personality and my comedy than I would have been able to do with my beauty. And I've learned that now.
So while you were growing up, you have faced, you know, criticism and then comments on your body.
Of course, like most girls do.
Exactly.
And I remember I was part of the tennis team, and there was a photograph of me and my tennis team, and we were all in short skirts and we were standing there. And a relative said, wow, your legs are bigger than everybody else's in the picture. They made that comment. I don't think anyone meant harm by that. No one was trying to insult me or put me down. But they just made the comment because, again, I think people feel like they have the right to comment on women's bodies. I don't know why people have a right to... like feel like you don't have a right to comment on anyone's body. Like it's you know, but they said like, oh, your legs are bigger than everyone else's. And I was 12. I just hit puberty, and that stuck with me until today. You will never see me in shorts. I will never wear a short skirt. You'll never see me in shorts. I am so conscious about my legs. I feel like my legs are so big, and I know it's in my head, but it's something that's I'm finding it very difficult to overcome that. But if you go on the internet, you will never find me in a short skirt or shorts.
If I may ask you this, what was the funniest comment you've received on your body?
I remember like one relative once told me, because my mom was very conventionally beautiful. It's very conventionally beautiful in terms of like, she has like thick hair and fair skin, and she was known for her beauty her whole life. And I remember one time this relative, when I was a teenager, was like, you know, Kaneez, you're not beautiful like your mother, but you're very charming. And I was like, oh, okay. Well, charming something as well, right? So I remember getting that comment from a relative once. Okay. I know, as a teenager, I'm like, don't tell teenagers. I think I remember once in the beginning of the comedy scene, I think Veer Das put out a tweet of us rehearsing something. And someone commented, Veer Das, why do you only work with such fat people? This is like the beginning of my career. I think this is like in 2012. And it really affected me because I was conscious about my body. And I remember thinking, I think it was like also a bad picture, like we were doing something and I was like, I ended up being like this.
Oh, wow.
And everyone's like, oh, it looks like, or something like, it looks like Veer Das only like hires really fat people. And I was like, wait a minute, like that's not even what I'm selling. I'm not even selling my looks and my body. I'm selling like my comedy. Like what difference does it make what I look like?
So you perform every night for people. You are, you know, millions of people all over the world are seeing you perform on comedy live, whether it's Netflix, you've got shows on Amazon, you're on YouTube, you're everywhere. But so do you still feel self-conscious when you go on stage?
No.
Or are you like, you know, you own the stage now, you're so confident and amazing, but have you always been that way, or was it like this journey that you went through?
It was this journey in accepting my body. And I think also like as a comedian, that's what I love about the stage, is that I get to go up there and express all, like I get to talk about all my insecurities, and I get to really just be actually like literally like almost 100% myself on stage. Like I will talk about everything that affects me, and because I get to make jokes on it, it makes me feel better about myself and my body. And that's funny. I just realized now that when I'm on stage, I feel so good about my body. When I'm off stage, I don't feel exactly the same way.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Like, I think the stage gives me, I feel like it gives me a superpower. I'm like, this is 100, like, this is me. Like, this is what you're going to get. Cool. And I'll be honest with you, I still have, like, certain body image issues. Like, I like that when it comes to my work, I don't worry about my body image. Like it's, I feel very comfortable showing exactly how I am on camera or on my social media, and that's not a problem. But when it comes to like dating men, I still feel conscious. Does that make sense? I'm really trying to get over that. Like, I want to feel good in my body everywhere, you know?
Yeah, and there's one more thing that's happening. People are, you know, hiding behind body positivity, but actually leading unhealthy lifestyles. And, you know, that's been the criticism for body positivity and self-acceptance all over, because they are leading unhealthy lifestyle, but they're saying, oh, we're body positive, so leave us alone.
That's the thing. Like, a lot of times people just assume that fat people are unhealthy. Mm-hmm. Like, maybe maybe larger people are living unhealthy lifestyles. But the thing is, a lot of people, most of us live unhealthy lifestyles. But then, like, bigger people have to adhere to higher standards of healthy lifestyle. There are a lot of thin people who also have extremely unhealthy lifestyles, and some of them are thin because of their unhealthy lifestyles. Okay. But we don't hold them accountable to their unhealthy lifestyles. If we're going to hold people accountable to healthy lifestyles on either side, then hold everyone, not just bigger people.
Right.
That's my thing on that. Like, okay.
I think everybody is trying to, I think in some way or whatever, trying to be healthier, to do their best to, you know, either lose weight, go to the gym, you know, be happier in their own selves.
Just have a stronger, healthier body.
Yeah.
And I don't think that always translates in how you look. I don't think like a strong and healthy body doesn't always translate in a skinny body.
Right.
Or like even a thin body.
Yeah.
Like, you know, sometimes there are really big people who are actually very healthy. Mm-hmm. So again, unless you have people's blood tests and reports, I don't think you can comment on whether or not someone's healthy.
Right. Yeah. Kaneez, you've had a career for 10 years in the comedy industry. What are your three pieces of advice that you can give women in India today?
I think one of the things, that's a lot. Okay, but I think one of the things that, like, focusing on your craft, like focusing on what you do and becoming better at, whether it's a craft or your job or whatever it is that you're passionate about, will give you so much more confidence than having a hot body or like perfect hair or skin. Like, I realized, even tomorrow, if I lost a ton of weight and I got this really hot body or hair and skin, like, that's not going to make me a better comedian. That's not going to make my audience love me more. Mm-hmm. That's not going to make me, you know, better at what I do. What I do and the my comedy comes from another place. It doesn't come from my confidence. It doesn't come from how I look. It doesn't come from the confidence of how I look. It comes from the confidence of having the skill that I'm really passionate about. The second one is finding my passion, which I know is not very easy, but even sometimes just finding something I like doing and then just like working on that craft. Mm-hmm. Like, whether it's like, you know, like I went, like I found improv and I loved it. And so I went to like festivals around the world to like learn about it more and went to America or like just read up a lot about it and watched a lot of stuff online and because I really love my craft. So like just honing something that you really love. Second thing is go back to old pictures of yourself and look at them and realize that for 10 years from now, you're going to look at pictures of what you look like now. You know, and like just talk to yourself. Like, even like I do this, I look at old pictures. I'm like, Kaneez, you were so, like, I actually talk to myself. And I'm like, you were so beautiful. Why did you hate yourself? And then I remind myself, Kaneez, make sure you don't do the same thing when you're 40, right, when you look back on yourself and you didn't like what you saw. So just like realize that you really are beautiful at every point in your life. And if you're not happy now, you're never going to be happy. And you know, I did like a few years ago, I lost weight and I look at pictures now and I'd lost a considerable amount of weight, but when I'd lost that weight, I still thought I was fat, which made me realize no matter what I do, if I don't change my perception of myself in my head, no matter how much weight I lose, no matter how beautiful, blah, 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 hair, skin, everything, it's not going to make a difference until I change the perception of myself.
And how did you do that?
Like, oh man.
Was it, so of course, like, we've been therapy. Talking about this. Yeah, because like, you said you hated yourself before.
I did. Like, I hated my body. And I was like, that's just an ugly body.
And then, and a lot of women go through this, whether whatever sizes we are, like my friends thinner than me are like, oh, we're too thin.
Yes.
Oh, we don't have this, we don't have that assets. The people who are bigger than me are like, oh, we're too big, we can't wear certain pants, we can't wear dresses. Everybody is going through it, including me. We all have, no matter what we have, we seem to find a problem with it.
So I think that's the biggest thing, was trying to break away from always dressing and styling myself relative to what I thought a man would want. So one thing is, that's changed now. Like, I also just have a group of really beautiful female friends who like have made me understand what that beauty is. Just so much, it's so different to like what women see as beauty is so different to what men see as beauty. And society has always told us that we need to attract men. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a big change, where I'm like, I'm not only going to exist for men. I'm not only going to dress and do whatever I'm doing to attract a man. I think that was one of the biggest changes that happened.
Wow. And okay, one fun question. If you had to redesign India's matrimonial ads for women,
oh my God,
what would be your take on it?
What exactly are matrimonial ads right now?
So there's like, the they same. Comment? They're tall, fair, okay, so beautiful.
I can write you a matrimonial ad that I know will never get any like callbacks.
Yes, that's what we need. Because
opinionated, empowered, independent, funny woman with strong opinions, career oriented, happy to be the breadwinner of the family. Right?
Yes.
Do you think that would be guys, amazing. We will never get, and no one will ever call this number. No one would ever.
But
happy with her body. Ooh. Happy with her body and her looks.
All sizes all, accepted.
All sizes accepted.
So thank you for sharing.
Thank you, Ananya.
This.
I really appreciate it.
Thanks.
Oh, so sweet. Thank you.